wanted Peter Parker not to be like the average superhero. I wanted him to be more like I had been when I was a teenager. Nerdy, not that popular, not too successful with females, a typical teenager. I had wanted to do this strip for a long time, and my publisher wouldn't let me. There were three things I will never forget that he told me. One, he said, Stan, you can't have a teenager as a superhero. They can only be sidekicks. I wanted Peter Parker to have a lot of problems. Personal problems, financial problems, romantic problems. And again, he said to me, don't you know what a superhero is? They don't have those kind of problems. And also, the name Spider-Man. He said, you can't call a hero Spider-Man. People hate spiders. The villains are actually either as important or more important than the hero. Because, you know, you've already introduced the hero. The reader hopefully cares about the hero, but it's who's he fighting next. You always try to get a villain who seems so powerful that your first instinct is to say, there's no way the hero can beat this guy. A lot of people ask me, how does it feel to see these characters come to life? I have been incredibly lucky because the people who bring them to life are so incredibly talented. Sam Raimi, who directs the Spider-Man movies, he's a genius. He's taken these stories that I wrote a long time ago, and he makes them seem greater than they really are. He does a great job. I get the credit. I love this arrangement. Same with the video games. When I see these video games and the artwork and the action and all the possibilities for the player, all the things he can do, I love it.